Today we'll take a look at how we can calculate and show ratios in Excel. So for example, let's say you want to show the ratio of managers to team members, or the ratio of managers to the total number of people in your project team. How can you calculate and show that in Excel? Let's jump in. In this example, I have 3 managers and 7 team members, and I want to show this as a ratio. Well, a ratio in Word format is very simple. It would be something like 3:7. This means that for every 3 managers, I have 7 team members. But a common way of showing ratios is to use colons. So 3:7 would be the answer here. Now, I want to get this with a formula, but as you can see, the logic is simple. All I'm doing is taking the first value here, putting it on the left-hand side, and then the second value goes on the right-hand side. That's all a ratio is. But one thing you'd want to consider is to show a simplified version of the ratio. So for example, if instead of 7 team members, we had 12, we don't want to show 3:12, although that's perfectly valid, but it's much easier to understand this ratio if we simplify this. We just have to find the greatest common factor here and divide each side with that factor. So in this case, the greatest common factor is 3. 3 divided by 3 would give me a 1, and 12 divided by 3 would give me 4. So I want to show this ratio up here as 1:4. Now, of course, we want to show this with a formula, and we're going to need a function that calculates this highest common factor. That's the GCD function. All we need to give it are our numbers. So in this case, my numbers are sitting together, so I'm going to select the range, but you can split this with a comma as well if you have your numbers in different places. Now, when I close bracket and press enter, I'm going to get a 3. Why am I not seeing a 3? Because my cell formatting has switched to time. Let's switch it to general, and I get a 3. Now, all I have to do is take this number here and divide it by the highest factor. This would give me the left-hand side, which is a 1. To get the right-hand side, I do the same thing, but with the other number. So my formula becomes this, and now I want to add the colon, so I'm going to use an and open the quotation, put in the colon, close quotation, and put in an and to continue with this function. Then I need to take this number, so for the team members, and divide this by the GCD of these two. Right, so this part of the formula stays the same. Now when I press enter, I get 1:4. If this was 7, it's 3:7. Now what if you had to calculate these numbers yourself? So your data set didn't give these numbers to you, but instead you had your data table set up like this. You just had roles and names, and you need to calculate the ratio of managers to team members. How do you come up with these numbers in the first place? Well, here we can just replace this with the COUNTIF function. First, we need the range. That's the range where we have team members and managers. And notice this is formatted as an Excel table. So I'm just selecting the column and I get the table annotation up here. Next, all I need is my criteria, which is manager, which I have in cell A3. So close bracket, press enter, and I get 5. Now I'm going to copy and paste this here because my references are dynamic. I don't need to update anything. So in this case, I have 5 managers for 14 team members. And because I'm using an Excel table, all of this is dynamic. If I add another team member to this, notice I get 1:3. If I needed to get the ratio of managers to total members, I just need to add these up. So instead of 15, I take 20. You can, of course, combine all of these steps and create a single formula. It's just that your final formula is going to become quite long because we're referencing cell B3 and B4 on this side and on this side, and B3 and B4 have formulas of their own. Now, if you have Office 365, you can take advantage of the let function and define names for parts of this final formula that are repeated. This makes your formula easier to read and more condensed. So in this case, I would want to define a name, let's say, for this function and this function. This way, I don't have to repeat it all the time inside the final function. Well, how do we do that? Let's do it down here. We're going to start off with the let function. We need to define a name for the formula or function or reference that we want to reuse. So I can call this manager, team member, but because we're doing dynamic references here, let's say the left and the right side of our ratio. So I'll call it left. Name value 1 is the part of my formula that I want to reuse later on. So this can be a cell reference, but it can also be a formula or function. I'm going to use the COUNTIF function I had in there. So I'll just quickly type it out. My range is this, and my criteria is this. I'm going to let this be dynamic. Okay, so let's close the COUNTIF, and now let's define another name for the team member part, so for the right-hand side. I'm just going to press Alt-Enter, and let's just expand this so we can see the formula better. Right is going to be the name of the second COUNTIF function, which is this one and this. Let's close the bracket. Now I'm going to do the calculation. So Alt-Enter, and my calculation is left, ampersand, colon, in quotation marks, and right. But remember, we still need the GCD formula. So let's go ahead and do that. It was left divided by GCD. And then I have left and right. And on this side, we have divided by GCD, also left and right. Right. So all I did here is to replace the cell referencing B3 and B4 with names. I call them left and right, and I defined what they were with the let function. Now, the way you use the let function is up to you. I could also add a separate name for the GCD function here so that I don't have to repeat this part in my final function. Once you're done, press Enter, and we get the same result back. Let's test it out. Let's quickly add another manager to this, and we get 2 to 5. So that's how you can easily calculate and show ratios in Excel. I hope you enjoyed this tip. Let me know if this is something you might need in your reports or if it's something you're already using. That's it for today. Thank you for being here. And if you're new and haven't subscribed to this channel, do consider subscribing before you leave, and I'll see you in the next video.